One of the things that was added in version 3 on the Versiv platform is the ability for automated fiber inspection. If you have the optional inspection camera, you probably already know by now that you can tap on Tools and Fiber Inspector and see how bad your end faces are. Prior to version 3, you'll see this grade here option. If I tap grade, you have the ability to manually say whether it's good or bad. But in the version 3 code, we added in automation, but it needs a test limit. So we need to set the test limit. So from the home screen, I'm going to tap where my test limit is. And actually, I've got one here as a default in the instrument. But if I tap new test, we see test type. If I tap test type, Fiber Inspector, and it will give me the test limit for multi-mode. Well, this is single mode, so I need to change it. So to change it, I tap test limit, more, and end face limits. And you'll see that I got 4 in here. The first one is for multi-mode, whether it's field polished or factory polished. The second one here is for single mode, and that's if it's factory polished. The third one here is for single mode again, but that's if you're doing a field polish. And then finally, we have the APC, the angled physical contact connector. So let's go ahead and select the factory polished one here. I'll save it. Here's my new test at the top here. So I'm going to highlight it, use selected. And if I hit test now, the difference this time is you'll see the analyze option. And if I got that focused in, now if I tap analyze, and it stopped because too many defects were found. Please clean the fiber and try again. This, as you can see, is just so bad. We need to do some basic cleaning. Let me go ahead and do that now. Put a little dab in there. Let's see what it looks like now. There's a play button, so I'm going to hit the play button. That's not too bad. It's getting a little bit better, but let's see what the tester says. I'll tap analyze. And you'll notice here that it's actually decided it's a fail. And this standard is kind of interesting. It creates 4 zones of acceptance, although only 3 of them are actually used. And on the tester here, where you see the red, that's where there's debris or dirt or a scratch that is outside of that defined standard. Interestingly enough, we don't actually count what's going on the outside here. So let me see if I can do a little bit of better job at cleaning up this connector. It's getting a bit better. We're not quite there yet. Zoom it back in. Analyze. And again, it's still failing. What is the conclusion here on this one? This cord is, I don't think it's going to be any good. When the cord is good, this is what you should see. Play. Focus it in. Analyze. And that's what a good cord looks like. Now you'll notice that there are some very small green dots in there where the instrument's picked up something, but that's well within what the standard permits. And as always, you have the option of saving the end face and save whatever keyboard IET you want to. And if you save that as the same as your optical loss test on the CertiFiber Pro or your OTDR test on the OptiFiber Pro, it will merge that result automatically. So then when you look at it in Linkware, you'll see the end face as well as your tier 1 or tier 2 test.